present. One of the reasons I asked her to present, and I'm glad she was willing, is because she has phenomenal classroom management. I went and filmed her the other day, and I mean, her students are on it, and she does the true classroom rotation model. So she rotates students from a teacher station to technology to maybe collaboration or projects or a third station. So if you haven't had that classroom rotation training from us, you will. And she has implemented this very well. It's the rotation where we feel is most successful for getting student engagement, for getting student one-on-one time, and being very helpful for teachers, and letting technology be a helpful tool for you. So I asked Maureen to present on that today because I have teachers say, well, how do I do this? So she's doing this and doing it well. So she's gonna be presenting on this today. So Maureen.
Thank you, Nikki.
Yes,
I am with O'Leary Middle School, Twin Falls School District. I use the blended learning. I love it. I kind of understand exactly where he came from, where growing up, I envisioned the computers, how they were gonna become. Before they were there, at the basic, okay, I can play my little games. No, I actually could see what was gonna happen with the future. So a little bit about who I am. I just finished up my master's from NNU with curriculum and instruction. I also graduated in 2008 with a bachelor's in K-12 elementary education, took the praxis, became a social studies teacher in sixth grade when we became a middle school. Later on, now I've been implementing for 1 year in the social studies curriculum, and I use Chromebooks to support my learning, just like he had. I have a set of 15, and yes, I would love to have a full classroom set, but at the moment, I'm happy with at least 15. The design. First thing you need to think about is how are you going to set it up the classroom? One, I had set it up at the beginning of the year, like Nikki mentioned, with three stations. With a 50-minute class period, that kind of becomes really restrictive. But I'll tell you the positive. When I had the block scheduling, it was phenomenal. That's exactly what I wanted to happen. And we'll talk about the pros and cons of each station setup I had to have done. In it, we've had about 13 minutes in station. And of course, we had the teacher station, reading station, computer station. On Buzz, I changed my icons to represent. That little icon up there became the teacher station folder. Teacher station, materials. I started recording my information, my lectures, so those students who were sick or absent could get access to it, or those that want review. And then of course, any reading materials or reading assignments would be in that reading station icon. Okay? So the pros that I had with this. I love the small groups. I had maximum 10 students. And that gave me that chance to get to know this group of people. Whereas these 10 in the regular classroom might have been overlooked. Okay? And so each time I went around, I learned different strengths and weaknesses of each student. The rotation prevented students from getting off task or getting bored. I mean, if you're up and moving every 15 or 13 to 15 minutes, you really truly did not have time to goof off. If you did, you would of course lose any chance of that. And of course, I had active engagement. No matter what station they were in, they had to be actively engaged to use that time in that station wisely. Yes, I did have students that chose to not participate completely, but that's given in every situation, and throughout the year, those students did learn how to be active and engaged learners. One of the best compliments was another sixth grade teacher on different prep. She goes, every time I walk back past your classroom, your students were engaged. She goes, I want to come into your classroom to see what's going on. The cons. In reality, to get in a 15-minute block, to have the students come in for the teacher whole station, sit down, get going, and then between rotating times, it was about 10 minutes maximum that they were truly in the lesson. So that was kind of, okay, the students started saying, this is too busy for me. I said, okay, let me see what I can do. I told my students, you guys are my test pilots. You tell me the feedback that you want me to know how to improve. Logging into computers. Sixth graders. They had to log into the Google, their Chromebooks. That means, well, we didn't start the year off with them having an email account set up because permission slips didn't get sent out until 2 or 3 weeks after school started. And then the students had to learn their email address. That doesn't mean it was always easy to happen. Then, of course, there was the, I forgot my password. I created a Google form, and it, one of my welcome stages is, help, Miss P, I forgot my password. Where they're supposed to go in and type in their Google password. So if they do that, I don't have to waste time sending them to tech person to have it reset, blah, blah, blah. I just try this. Oh, okay. So that saved a lot of headaches. But still, the time to get into the Chromebooks after they got their Google passwords, get into Buzz, which, okay, once they got logged into a Chromebook, it was wonderful. Everything was saved, password, you know, I taught them how to bookmark, things like that. And my computer went to sleep. Oh, no. I hope it's going to pull back up.
I'll work on that later.
Okay.
We'll change there. That to not go to sleep.
Thank you. Okay. In the meantime, 10 minutes, it's really? Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to change it so
go
I
ahead.
Can go to sleep, though. Is that okay?
So.
Do you need to go to the next slide or anything?
Let's see. Sure, put us on two-station rotation. Two-station rotation, though. Halfway through the year. Okay, well, before I go to the two-station, I did do a three-station where we only rotated twice then. But then I had to have a little chart and each day, then they'd have to say, okay, where are we starting today? And so that was fun, but confusing. The students that loved it, they hit like, ooh, every day is a new day. But the students that get lost easily, sixth graders, they got confused. So of course, I said, okay, this is still not working. So we went to just a two-station rotation. And in that two-station rotation, we actually had what's called a, Nikki, would this help? It won't go to sleep, it's plugged in.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, we had two stations now. Oh, one other con about the three station was sometimes in the reading stations, I started noticing that some students were chatting more than partner reading. Yeah, I know, shocking. Okay, so I said, okay, this is kind of getting confusing. Let me simplify our lives again. Again, I have 15 Chromebooks, so I turn it into a two-station rotation. I had 15 seats facing the wall away from where I had the big U. Majority of the time, I had my students in a big U. So that way they could collaborate together, they could partner share, things like that, without disrupting the computer station. I also could keep track of my computer station. And you're gonna see how I monitored my classroom a little bit later on. But this was my little area that I just rolled around in all the time. I could see the computers over there, and I could see what was on their screens. To help monitor whether or not they're on task. Again, the pros and cons. I found more pros with this. Again, I still had my small groups. I had about 15 students now per station. It increased it by 5, and that did change the dynamics some, but it was still not 30 plus students trying to keep on task at one time. Or trying to answer, I'm confused about this, or I'm confused about that. It was only 15 at a time. They were able to rotate, on average, about 18 minutes. You gotta kind of count in transition, movement time, things like that. A little bit of a breather time. So it was on average about 18 minutes on task behavior. And then of course, still prevented no board time, because if they use our time wisely and sat down and got on task to get the assignment completed that I laid out in front of them, they had to be on task. And of course, the best of all, 18 minutes you can actually have a depth of a conversation. Or they can watch a video completely. Or other things like that, instead of having to pause in between, stuff like that. It increased the time on task, but some students, and that's why I put it under here as a con, and I actually gave a survey at the end, and some of the students' responses were that I wish you would have just taught one thing all the time. Like computers, we're on the computer the whole class period. Or we're doing this assignment the whole class period. I said, okay, well, all right, so maybe for those students the transition is too much. And again, the logging into and out of the computers seemed to take up a little bit of time. Sometimes I think most of that was self-imposed. So as I was saying, I gave a survey at the end. This is based off of a Likert scale of 1 to 5. And I asked some of the students some of these questions and got their feedback. For example, one of the best things they loved was the reading checks. I'm going to talk a little bit about this, but this was how they stayed organized. Okay. I also would give them a worksheet type of thing that they were to find certain answers and from the readings. And then they would go on as a practice assignment and do that, check your answers, to make sure that when you were taking those notes from the reading, you got the important things. So that's what that reading checks were. We also used them for videos to make sure that they were getting the important details I wanted from the videos. Again, you can see that the small group rotation was nice. The videos, the students tended to love being able to watch the video on their own. The feedback I had from students, the written feedback, was that they enjoyed it because they didn't have to be interrupted by other students that were not respectful. Plus, I taught them how to turn on the closed caption. If taking notes, I said, okay, now, disclaimer, it does not always go with word for word. Sometimes you might see the word, they might say the word ask, but it's not what's written in the closed captioning. So we're going to be mature about this, giggle a little bit, but okay, it's not a bad thing, just move on. And the students did. They were really mature about it. I mean, first few times they giggled and stuff, but out to that, no. You can also see up here, all my results were strong at the positive end. The zeros were, or the ones were negative, or didn't like, and the fives were strong. So it's really helpful for me to see that they liked it, that they enjoyed this online environment. Here were some of the quotes that I just picked out a few from the survey. Of course, asked about using blended learning. They go, I love it. I like the second one. They got more experience using different classes. And I'm assuming that person meant classes as in, okay, we are on the computers, that was a class. We were with a teacher, that was a class. Or we had a reading assignment, that was a class. Students don't all learn the same way, we know that. So using my blended environment, I'm able to address all the different types of learners. Again, crowded. They liked the fact that they were not crowded in big groups. They had that chance to communicate, and they love the fact of getting a balanced learning environment. Okay? And having a break. So I chose 3 cons because majority of the cons were about the same thing. Rotation times were too fast. sometimes we get started, then we have to stop and go to our next station, and you know, from one to the next, and would confuse me. Again, the idea that doing different things felt confusing to them. But this is their first time doing something like this. They might have done stations as little kids, but where the classroom was set up with this concept of half the time you're on a computer, you're completely independent, and this is what you need to do, and half the time you're here, was different. So just a few of the students posted. I definitely had to have clear expectations. We had to enter the classroom. We've taught this to our sixth grade students that you wait outside the doorway until you're welcomed in. Help alleviate the crowding of the students. I love that one. In my room, they have to move one way. We come in the door, we walk around the room, we go in a one-way pattern. Again, safety, plus with the Chromebooks on computers, I really want it to be safe. Leave the stuff at the binder sitting and composition books. Rotating the one-way walking, quickly and quietly. This was seen, I mean, Nikki said that I had a great classroom, and I'm like, yeah, but she saw at the end of the year. When this was working. And of course, computer safety and etiquette, that's something you have to address again and again. As the students start to develop and learn the tools, you need to help them understand what true safety is like. This is what I love, binder sitting. I have a shelf in the back of my room, part of the one-way model. They come in, they go to the back of the room. They're to leave their big binders they tow from class to class there. Only thing I really want with them in their seats is a composition book. Because this and a pencil or a pen is a lot easier to move from here to there. And like another thing with composition books, you glue the pages in and they have it. John brought up the idea of getting away from paper even more. Yes. I really am not going to be spending that much more time. This was 1 year's composition. I had some students that had two books because it got quite full. But I'm thinking that I'm going to save more trees even more next year. Positive management. One thing that Nikki saw that she commented on, she was like, oh, that was so awesome. Cubs Cash. Oh, Larry Middle School, we have implemented the PBIS model, positive behavioral intervention and supports. And we just did tier one last year, just getting a start. It is a great idea because it rewards the good students, which we all want to do. But in a classroom, when you have little Johnny off task, who do you notice more? Little Johnny versus little Susie, who's quietly doing their work, being very good students. And so they came up with that. For me in my classroom, it didn't really give me the time to reward the good behaviors. So I came up with another idea. Whoa, sorry, that's the PBS website. Okay, yeah, that is the one there, the PBIS.org. Awesome, pause. Turn to post. All right. We give out Cubs Cash, that's what they call it. But they could earn Cubs Cash for being walking on the right side of the hallway, for picking up trash, for various random things. I mean, they're kind of pre-established, but anything and everything you could think of, you could give a reward for. I got tired of saying, let me see. Oh, there's good job. You know, that was just too much. So the awesome possum idea came up. But even better, I wanted to reward those good students. So as they entered my room, I ended up giving them two awesome possums as they came in my room. With that, of course, they had a chance to earn more. I love the fact that you brought up Quizlet, because I have a Quizlet mastery, Cubs Cash, that before the test, those people that are at the top of that score, the top 10, they would get Quizlet Mastery, Cubs Cash. Academics, no missing work. I like to reward those still. But I wanted to start the day off positive. Everybody, I don't care who they are, when they walk in my room, we're saying, you did awesome. Stay that way. And so, yeah. But this was the best part of it. They're able to purchase freedoms. Social studies teacher, remember? Okay, they could bribe their official to get out of trouble. Right? Little Sally is very talkative. Well, she's interrupting the learning environment. Pay me. She runs out of Cubs Cash. Guess what she fills out next? The refocus form. I don't have to go over and say this or that. You don't have your supplies. Pay me. I'll take care of it for you today. They run out again. Well, I guess we do a write-up now. So it saved me a lot of paperwork because as long as they had that Cubs Cash, we were fine. You also started seeing good characters being developed because maybe a peer would have a chance to step in and say, hey, I'll cover you this time. So students could see people in different light. Had quite a few people there. Also, worksheets. Oh, I loved it. If for some reason they lost their worksheets or fell out or whatever and they needed it, guess what? They had to pay to get a new one. It's amazing how many went down. They didn't have their composition books on their desk. They had to pay me. So as they came into my room right away, they got a chance to get two and keep it. So our little students that are great and behave properly, they got to keep them. Nevertheless, those that need a little free out, they also had a chance. This was one of the special rights that people loved. They could sit on my chair. And this was the chair that I used to roll around. It had me high enough that I could see above all the students. And for me, that was really impressive. But also, I didn't have to bend over in front of somebody. And as I said, put my Guatemala in their faces. It was wonderful. That too.
Yeah.
Nope, I just sit down, I would ride it like a horse style and just roll around the room. Kids laughed at it as well. But they loved the idea of sitting in my office chairs. This one especially, which cost them more Cubs Cash, because that means that I would have to get out of it. But also the office chairs I had in my room. I had about 3 or 4 of them, the rolling kind. They could also sit by their friends. So that's one of those management styles that when Nikki came in, it had been established, the students accepted it. In fact, they reminded me if I didn't give the Cubs Cash, can I pass it out today? Yeah, great. Other days that I'm on the ball and I'm actually in the hallway where I'm supposed to be, yeah, I'm passing them out as they're entering, which is a great way of, hey, welcome to class. Good job. Glad to have you here. Just one of those nice things. Paul Levy. So here you will need your technology device because we're going to be going into Poll EV in a minute. But I use it as an online survey tool, use it a lot as the bell ringers, and it has a variety of response options. One of the best things I loved about Poll EV was like the students set up here, I could ask simple questions or I could ask more elaborate ones. Of course, I had to get the comment where everybody knows that Princess Pedula didn't conquer the Aztecs. That was one of my responses, like you said, to have fun. So let's go to a sample poll. Here's how you're gonna go ahead and get into it. There is 3 different ways. You could do it by texting. If you text the word Pedula to 37607, that will enroll you in my class, and anytime I submit a poll, it automatically pulls it up for you. It will submit it on your digital devices. If you want to go onto it in Twitter, I just started, I'll give that one a go. The tweet at PedjuliaMA, and it will have the response. But this is the one that most of the students did, pollev.com/Pedjulia. And that is PADILHA. Okay? And let's see what the results are. Yes, I have it going.
dangerous for the sixth graders. Please put it back.
Is it all caps?
All caps. Well, it doesn't have to be all caps there.
Okay,
hold on. Well, I didn't want to hide it. I want to go full screen. Come on. Sure. I don't know. I found that you could get an app for your Mac for PolyV. And then it just gives you the option to jump to and all this stuff. I'm like, oh, cool. But it doesn't want to present it in full screen. That's interesting. So, again, it tells you right there again as well what three choices you could get it in as.
It's not letting me.
It didn't let you do it?
Who
said that? Okay, can you do that tweet?
Did I
do
okay?
Yeah, but okay.
This isn't a tweet, it's a message.
Oh, it's a message.
Text message.
Yeah.
707.
Uh-huh. Idaho. Idaho, yeah. You should have gotten a reply like, welcome to the community. PolyV.com is it easier. Just leave it on your computer. Works just as easy. The students actually enjoy it. And this is a good one if you want to do like a real vocabulary review and everybody has a device. Or if you're wanting to do like a jigsaw puzzle reading and then everybody had to put up their summary. I could change. Right now I have them just randomly popping up and down. You can see that the things here become bigger or smaller as people come in. So the students do tend to enjoy it. You could change the size of the headings and things like that. So that when the student, because if it's on a presentation, the students all have their devices, they don't need to see the question very large up here, because they'd want to see the responses more. And it just randomly goes through it. So we've got Google Classroom, some people are just starting, watching videos, yes. I love the idea of just simply watching the videos. Because you never have enough time to let them watch the videos you really want them to watch. Using the blended learning, you're discussing, reading, working. They go over there, review with a video. That is blended learning. Okay? Yeah? Now, not only do you want to work with your struggling learners, you also want to work with your advanced learners. That was one of the best things about this. My honor students that were not honors in my classroom, but you know, the language, science, math, those students, they thrived in this classroom. And as I believe we're going to be working about later on with the running man and the ghost self in Buzz, showing you how they can keep track of their progress and everything, this was wonderful. Because those students are very competitive. Okay, we're going to go out back into the thing. You're going to have another presentation real soon. Which, like I said, like I use this. I review for EOCs. Truly, when I'm doing this, it's the students know what it's going to be. And so.
And even that, my third graders love it.
Yes.
It's so interactive.
It is. And the sixth graders love putting hashtag and after their and a handle after their responses, so they knew that was their response. And so it has a lot of fun because later on, okay, we'd be reviewing for questions and I'd see what the responses the people would make, and then I'd type in. I'm just sitting in the back of the room or whatever, and so I type in a response and I put hashtag Rosa, which happens to be my dog, and the kids are like, Miss P, is that you? I went, yeah. So what's the right answer? I go, Rosa knows it. And, you know, so that was fun. But everybody had a chance to put in their 2 cents, just like you guys all had a chance. Will I have students that didn't do it? Yes. If I pay, I think I can actually keep track of who absolutely does something. It looks like PolyV's upgraded their services and does keep track of a history. thankfully, but at the same time, it's there. So some of the other questions on that survey I asked the students was, with technology, were they able to connect? And again, we're over half, you know, not exactly fours, but 3.5 response as an average. I pushed really hard to use that email. If you got a question for a teacher, ask it in email. That way the teacher can reflect back upon it at their time when they're not being bombarded by 20 or 30 other students. And we had quite a few students that really did that. Tracking the progress and buzz. Yes. You're going to have this little, anybody that they have a little running man, where the person should be, the ghost self, and the person where they're at. It will help keep track, and some people love it when they go past the running man or the ghost self where they should have been, which is if they get their assignment done before the due date, that's what happens. Using pulley B was strong as well. Discussion boards dropped down. That could be because I didn't do discussion boards right away at the beginning of the year. We didn't start them until the later on, and some of the students did not understand the usefulness of discussion boards. I used Edmodo before I used Buzz and for those type of discussions. I didn't use Edmodo last year because I didn't want to confuse the students more. I like Edmodo for some things where students can go in and actually start conversations and go deeper in their knowledge. But again, I'm dealing with sixth graders where sometimes the maturity does not always outweigh the smarts. So discussion boards can become positive the more we go. I asked them if they're willing to take it. Some students said depends upon the subject. Some students said never again if I don't have to. But I knew that the students leaving my classroom were prepared. The strongest one here, Google Docs, or basically Google Apps. The students loved it. Now, the best thing about Buzz versus Google Classroom is that Buzz requires students to know how to link or download or upload documents, which is Common Core requirement of knowing how to do those things. That's part of college readiness. So Buzz will require the students to know that. But the students learn how to collaborate, work together, how to not get mad if a student happens to delete something because they found out you can do a control Z and get it back. It was awesome this last year. Our EOC review guide, I said, okay guys, here it is. I put it up on Google Docs. They went in and filled in the information. So those struggling students, did they get all the information then? Yes. Those that are more achieving, they went out and found, or maybe struggling students went out and found a picture for it instead of the definitions, or maybe, you know, they added the picture after the information was put in. So everybody had a chance to add to it, and not only did one person, okay, well, I didn't get it done. Well, no, we got it done as a class, we got it done. And my test results at the end were quite nice, about 76% average. The one class that I had the most IEP kids, ironically, I had my most honor kids, level kids, and my most IEP kids all in one classroom. That classroom scored 87% on my EOC. Yes, my honor students probably were the higher bouts, but my IEP kids, they were not below 70. No, they did not drag them down like I had in other class periods. So, Google Apps, great for collaboration. If it's just a beginning start for you guys, great. In conclusion, we do have another poll. It should be opened up already on your slides. Why do I like it? Well, I liked it because I taught students how to be independent. They learned how to find their answers. I don't think I remember seeing Quizlet up there, but Quizlet. By the end of the year, with the EOC study guide, I didn't make up a Quizlet set. The students did it. They took that Google Doc where they put information in. They said, Ms. P, is this correct? I went through, I said, oh, that one doesn't look right, so I crossed it off. They went back and fixed it. Is it correct now? Oh, that looks a lot better, yes. Then they took that and turned it into a Quizlet set. I had another student who realized, hey, this is the same stuff we've covered all year. Can't I just use all the vocab terms from all year and combine them into one big set? Absolutely. Told the students later on, I said, hey, okay, we got this one set here of 50 Quizlet questions. We got this one of 250. I would suggest you study this one before you do that one for the EOC. You know, in other words, that student who turned them all into one, she, of course, was my honor student, but she was actually one who started building them, adding pictures into it, things like that. You could do some for free, but of course you want to do the paid up one. Another one, the content. With our Common Core, where we're required to do all these other requirements, you need it. Next year, we're going to have our math teachers get on board. So we're going to be implementing more there. But the Khan Academy, get them half the time there, half the time small groups. Perfect. Maybe half the time direct instruction, where the other half, they're practicing and then their own videos, reviewing. Wonderful. My students started realizing that if they were going through this, the information was very circular. Because I had to put it in as they occurred. But okay, so in my computer station, we did this video. In my teacher's directed station, we did this assignment. Oh, but that was about that video. And then in the reading station, we're reading about the information that's in the teacher directed information. So it was a circular method where everything just kind of blended together. And towards the end, those IEP kids that couldn't handle it in the beginning, or my struggling students that couldn't do it in the beginning, they did thrive. My lowest scores, well, they tend to be my lowest scores all year round, and that was all class subjects. So I couldn't consider them my lowest scores. On average, I'd say my students ranged from 70 or above by the end. In the beginning, they didn't start that way. So, if you have questions, comments, take a look at what the full EB has to show, and we'll go from there. This is what it kind of looks like, the back side of it, where you can change, choose what you want. You have the test examples, where it tells you what you have here. You can push the questions out. You can put a timers on it. Talks to you about how you can change your presentations. You can download it as a slide, PowerPoint slides. I didn't really want to do that this time, but I have done it in the past. And of course, over here you can change your settings to a text wall. Word clouds are wonderful. I asked my students for summer school, which I'm just getting implemented. What did you like about social studies? So they did it in there. The most larger the word is, the more you see it. You got a cluster and a tickers, or just keeps going like that. Any questions or anything you'd like to see? I can show you some examples of my Google Docs, my examples in Buzz, anything that you would like to see.
Well, I think at this point, because it is lunch right yes. now, right? Mm-hmm. So we never want to stand between people and lunch.
No.
So hold that thought, and we do have, our next session will be roundtables and group work mm-hmm. together, where I think you would be very valuable to have a group to maybe have okay. to work on stuff. And when those, and then also we have our work session as our last session. So
okay.
we'll leave you available for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.